three moves for a firm, tight butt. So we have three different things. We have deadlift, we have bridge, and then we also have lateral step. Okay, so we have beginner, intermediate, and advanced. So lots of different variations. So if you feel like you're not quite advanced enough, you can start at the beginner level. So three different moves that are gonna get that butt nice and tight, all right? Let's go ahead and start. You're gonna grab a pair of dumbbells. I have 10 pounds here, but you can go anywhere from 5 to 12. We're gonna start in the beginner version of the deadlift. So we're gonna go into a deadlift squat. So I'm gonna bend my knees at about a 90 degree angle, and then I'm gonna lower my chest and then come right back up, okay? I'm squeezing my glutes the entire time, especially as I come all the way back up to stand, all right? Also, you wanna make sure that your core stays tight so you don't tweak anything in that back, all right? So the next variation is actually gonna be something similar, but we're not gonna bend quite as deep. So look at the angle of my legs, okay? I'm gonna soften these just a little bit, and again, we're gonna lower dumbbells towards the ground and come right back up and lower. And come right back up. So similar thing, just a little bit less bend in the knees, keeping the core tight the entire time. Now, advanced version or hard version, you're gonna go ahead and put the weight into one leg and allow the weight of the dumbbells to kind of carry your chest forward, and then you're gonna go ahead and return the standing position, okay? So we're gonna stay on that one leg for about 15 reps, making sure that my hips stay square, hold, and then come all the way back up to stand. Then I'm gonna switch sides, okay? That's a great way to isolate and make sure that you have, you know, different balances. Make sure you're not too heavy on one side. All right, so I'm gonna put the dumbbells on off to the side. We're gonna start with some bridges. First is our couch bridge. So I don't have a couch, but I do have a bench. So what I'm gonna do is place my feet on that bench. I'm gonna arms by my side, palms face the ground. Look up towards the ceiling, and I'm just gonna inhale, lift my hips all the way up, and exhale, release down. And inhale, lifting up, and exhale, releasing down. So this is our beginner version of the couch bridge. Now, my intermediate version would be placing the weight into one leg. So I'm gonna lift my left leg off of the bench, lift my hips off of the ground. This way I really isolate my right glute. And whenever I come down, I'm not resting on the ground. I'm just lowering my hips just for a second or so, and then coming right back up. So I have 12 to 15 reps on one side, and then I'm gonna switch that opposite side. Now, the more advanced variation, you're gonna grab hold of that stability ball, and you're gonna go ahead and place your feet on top of that ball. Stability balls is a great way to challenge your balance, especially if you're working on your glutes or your core. So I'm gonna go ahead, same way my bridge started on the couch, my feet are gonna be flat on that stability ball, lifting my hips, and I really feel it, not just in my glutes, but I also feel it in my hamstrings, okay? So I'm gonna lift my hips all the way up, look up towards the ceiling, and release down. And if you wanna make this even more challenging, what you can do is you can lift one leg and then lower, and then lift the opposite leg and then lower. Okay, so lots of different variations for you to try. So you can start on that couch bridge and then work your way up to that stability ball bridge, okay? Next, we're gonna go into that lateral step. I'm gonna grab my dumbbells once again. I got my 10 pounders handy. So if I have my step close by, I'm gonna go ahead and take a lateral step up on that bench, hold here and lift that leg, holding for about 3 counts, and then come right back down, okay? So this is that beginner version. We're just kind of hovering that leg, finding stability in the standing leg, and then returning to stand, okay? Now, more intermediate, I'm gonna step on that, and then I'm gonna lift my leg about 45 degree angle, hold for 3 counts, and then return to stand. Same thing, 45 degree angle, and of course, I'm gonna repeat this on both sides. Now, more advanced, this becomes a hop. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put my dumbbells aside and I'm gonna really work on a little bit of plyometric movement. So this is the lateral jump. So you're gonna hop to the right side, hop to the left side, okay? And as you get more comfortable with this movement, you can work on more lateral distance. Maybe you even touch the ground, okay? Challenge yourself. Or you can add some weight here. So lots of different ways for you to change it up and get a nice, firm, tight butt. I'll see you guys soon.